Hello you awesome possums! When it comes to flying ESFs or flying in general in Planetside 2, I think we can all agree that there's quite a learning curve because the flight mechanic is a bit different. To some, it feels counterintuitive and hard. To others, it's as easy as coming up with an answer when you ask your girl where she wants to eat and she says you decide. But given that infantry fights is the bread and butter of the game, it's safe to assume that a lot of players prefer keeping their boots on the ground. But at some point, these players will feel the need. The need for speed. Ow! That was a Top Gun reference, by the way, and some of you might not get it. Anyway, today I have the 5 stages of learning to fly ESFs in Planetside 2. Let's dive into it. Or should I say, let's fly into-
Just started already!
Okay, I'm sorry. Stage 1, the turning point. This is the time when you say, that's it, I'll start flying in this game. But let's talk about how you got to that point. And by you, I mean me. This is where it all starts. Like I said earlier, getting our boots dirty is the name of the game in this, well, game. You're fighting with your brothers and sisters in arms and giving it your all even if you have the aim of a bar of soap. And by you, I mean me. Then this happens. Along comes an ESF, raining death on everyone like a blessing from an angel. If you know, angels had rockets. Now, getting destroyed by these flying cardboards for the first couple of times is not so bad because hey, it's part of the game, right? However, this is what irks you the most. And by you, I mean me. And I just said irks. Who says irks nowadays? Anyway, what's frustrating is they seem to come from nowhere, and what's worse is a lot of times you cannot fight back. Even if you can, it'll be too late by the time you notice. Now, you realize you're up to here with these ESFs, up to here, like up to- I'm doing the up to here gesture, but I guess there's no point since you can't see me, so I'll put something in instead.
Now I'm here.
Then you decide to take it to the skies of Araxis, which leads us to stage 2, the cocky pilot. Out of spite, you decide to hop into an ESF that probably doesn't belong to you. And for that matter, you're probably not even qualified to fly to begin with. But, eh, who am I kidding? Everyone knows that in shooter games, if there's a plane, then every soldier is a certified pilot. Anyway, so you're finally flying your ship thinking, how hard can this be? Because you have the confidence and you feel like you're Anakin Skywalker when he hopped into that starfighter in Phantom Menace. But then, you realize you have as much flying skills as a dead Wookiee. I'm sorry, that was stupid. No, but seriously, in this stage, you just know this is not gonna work. You wobble uncontrollably, you crash repeatedly, your aim has gone from bad to abysmal. And by you, I mean me. But you won't give up just yet. Because you know you just need one semester in flight school, which coincidentally is stage 3, the flight school. This is where legends in the air are made, like Amelia Earhart, Richard Best, Sully, and Jim Kirk. Just like these 4 real-life historically accurate legends, you'll be able to practice flying in a futuristic, virtual reality world that is definitely not a ripoff of the Danger Room in X-Men. Also, because they definitely had that tech for training. But I digress. You're here to work on being the deadliest pilot in Planetside 2 history. You work on your aim, your flight maneuvers, and you test the weaponry that suits your flying style. With unlimited nanites, you can spawn as many ESFs as you want and crash all you want. But rest assured, by the time you leave the VR training facility, you will leave as cool as Tom Cruise as Maverick in Top Gun, if not cooler. Speaking of Maverick, we're now in stage 4, the Maverick. You did the miles, you've done the hours, now it's time to soar and take the fight to the sky- Oh for f**k's sake. It's time to soar and take the fight to the skies. Your training has indeed paid off. Sort of. You're no longer flying like you're drunk, you can at least aim properly, hell, you can finally get some kills with your ESF. I mean, that guy probably has a family to feed, but you know, as long as you're happy, right? The point is, you still have a long way to go, but what matters the most is, you're learning and improving every time. I'm actually giving myself a pep talk about my YouTube channel. I'm kidding. But since we're on the topic of my channel, if you're enjoying the video, please give it a like and please subscribe as well because it will really, really help the channel grow. I mean, I'm not aiming to be on a Mr. Beast level, but I'd really appreciate it if you subscribe. And of course, the final and simplest stage of all, stage 5, the full circle. You already have some aerial combat experience and you probably regret spending the certs on that upgrade a bit. And by you, I mean me. You have now come to a full realization that flying is just not your thing in this game. But you're still fine with it because you know you'll take it to the skies every now and then. Maybe not regularly, but you know, when you feel like it. Okay, on a serious note, the flying mechanic is indeed different in Planetside 2 compared to other games. If you came from Battlefield, Ace Combat, Star Wars Battlefront, and so on, you will see the difference straight away. Of course, some people are really good at it, and some just won't even bother. In my case, it's definitely not my cup of tea, and not only that, I also get motion sickness in any first-person flying games. If you have the same condition as me, then I'm sure you understand what I'm talking about here. Honestly, it can go for about a few minutes until the motion sickness kicks in, and that's it. But if you need some actual tips on flying ESFs or air-to-air combat, you can check out the video guide by Dudisfludis. Dudisfludis? Yeah, this is actually in the game launcher right now, so link is down in the description. How about you guys? Leave your learning experience down in the comments, or share your tips for the aspiring pilots. That's that for today, and I will see you in the next one. Stay safe and stay awesome, Possum.